What were your thoughts and feelings upon meeting, seeing in person Daw Aung San Suu Kyi for the first time, and what do you make of the progress toward reform?
Well, it was sort of an emotional moment. I followed this issue for some 20 years. I remember reading about the election they had in 1990 and the fact that the junta canceled the election and put her under house arrest, where she remained most of the time for the next 20 years. Won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1991, was not able to accept it. It's been a long march there, and I must tell you, I never really thought things would change. I mean, we passed sanctions legislation on her advice a number of years ago, and they had been, you know, treated like a pariah by ASEAN, but it seemed like nothing was ever going to change. And they had an election in 2010, chose a new constitution. We all thought it was a flawed election, which it was, but they began to change. And the president opened up discussions with Aung San Suu Kyi, leading to her becoming convinced that he was a genuine reformer. Just the week I was there, they were releasing political prisoners, many of whom had been in jail for 20 years. In fact, I met with a couple of them right after the day after they got out. And much of the discussion that was going on was to verify with the government that everybody had gotten out. In other words, they were openly discussing, you know, whether this individual was a common criminal or a political dissident, but it was a cooperative discussion. The by-election, April 1st, she's chosen to compete in it. All of this is a dramatic pace of change. Now, Burmese citizens are not going to see an immediate improvement in their lives. And one thing that I mentioned to both Suu Kyi and to the president and to those in the government is you have so many problems. Try to isolate a couple of things you can do that people will notice and will believe is an indication that having elections and choosing your own leadership actually makes a difference in my life. And if she wins on April 1st, and I think we'd all be shocked if she didn't, that she will actually be in the government. So she's made a conscious decision to be a real politician, somebody who actually has to accept responsibility for outcomes and potential criticism for lack of outcomes, not just a symbol, but an actual political figure. I think all of that is very hopeful and an amazing change over a relatively short period of time here just in the last year and a half.
I imagine you've been in communication with Mrs. Clinton, the department. I imagine you supported the ambassador change the administration made. Does this relate to China? Is that the U.S. interest? Is it reversible, and how should Mrs. Clinton and Mr. Obama deal with sanctions?
Well, two good questions. I did support the decision the secretary made. In fact, we talked the morning I left, and she felt like enough progress had been made already to warrant having an ambassador there. I agree with that. I think it was the right thing to do. The other issue you raise, a very important issue, is that there were times when those of us who were involved in the sanctions legislation wondered if it made any difference. Well, my conclusion is, since all of the government officials kept bringing it up, that maybe it did make a difference. And we need to be very cautious in undoing the sanctions. They need to be met with reciprocal actions on the part of the Burmese government. And I think the next focus of attention is going to be the April 1st election. Is it free and fair? And further progress toward peace with the various ethnic minority groups. If those kind of things happen, then I think it's time to begin to look at undoing some of the sanctions.